Hello, gamers. My name is Dr. Crowder, and I'll be the coach of the High School Esports League here at Alliance Academy for Innovation. If after today's presentation you'd like to learn more about HSEL, go to www.highschoolesportsleague.com and you can learn more. So today our presentation is going to be about the High School Esports League, which is a community of 3,400 plus schools and 140,000 students all around the world who compete against each other in esports. Probably a question that everybody's asking is, what are the games that we play in the High School Esports League? First up is Rocket League. Rocket League is free to play. The way that High School Esports League works is there is a fall major tournament and a spring major tournament. You can register to play for free. That is no charge to participate in Rocket League. EA Sports Madden is another game that is hosted by High School Esports League, and that one is also free to play. Now, you have to own the game and you have to own the console to play any of these games, but to participate in High School Esports League is free. Super Smash Brothers is one of the sports that we play in High School Esports League. That one is not free. So if you want to participate in the fall major, that is a $40 fee and you are guaranteed up to 12 games, or no less than 12 games. Hearthstone is a game that we play as part of the High School Esports League. Also, this one is not free, so again, $40 to participate in the fall major or the spring major. NBA 2K22 is free to play. Again, you have to own the game and the console to participate, but there is no charge to participate in the tournaments. Minecraft is another game that we play. Again, not free to play. A $40 fee to participate in the spring major. Chess.com is free to play. Play chess online against others. Chess.com is free to access and then free to play against others. That one is not no charge there. As I've mentioned a couple of times, the platform pricing, as you can read here, and this is also again detailed on their website. There is a free pass if you want to compete in the Summer Challenge, which just wrapped up, so that's over. But if you want to just keep that in mind, you can play in the Summer Challenge, and all games are free. You have up to $4,000 in scholarships for that tournament. The one that is now open for registration, so when you register today, we'll have an organizational meeting next Tuesday. For the games that I mentioned that are free, they're free. However, the ones that aren't free, like Super Smash Bros., then there is a $40 individual pass for you to play in that. And it is pay to play. So if you want to play in that tournament, then you'll pay the $40 individual pass. And I'll talk more about that at our meeting. If it gets to the point where I feel like that there's, that we could collect a less amount of money and buy the $850 per school, then that gets us unlimited entries into one of the tournaments. So we'd have to, get in to see how many kids are interested in order to figure that out. But you can pretty much count on paying $40 if you want to play in the spring or fall major. The fall major, again, is being registered for right now. You get 12 plus games, $15,000 in scholarship is up for grabs. And lots of other things. Okay, so if you would like to join, it's only $20 to join, includes a t-shirt. It is now open on My Payments Plus, so you can go for the Esports League and sign up. And again, it's $20 to join. Also, go ahead and scan this QR code and provide the information for our team roster, and you can sign up. One more thing, we're going to be having a team organizational meeting next Tuesday at 4 p.m. Each sport will have a captain and a co-captain, and they're going to help the members of each league who participate in that sport. So if, let's say, Super Smash Brothers is going to need a captain and a co-captain, Madden will need a captain and a co-captain, and your job is to build others up, coach them on tips on how they can get better, so perhaps scrimmage with them and give them tips on, and advice on how we can get better as a team and be a good leader. In general, on this team, it will be required that you're a good sport, a good student, a good person, and I don't want to put up with any trolls. So if you're a troll, just, go somewhere and be a part of another team, because I'm not going to put up with any being mean to each other. We are a team, and I expect you to be, again, a good sport, a good student, and a good person. So go ahead and scan that QR code and join up to the Discord. That's what the QR code is, and you can be a member of our online meeting this Tuesday at 4 o'clock. If you have any questions about this, again, my name is Dr. Crowder. My office is located in the Innovation Lounge or Media Center. Stop by and say hello, but go ahead and fill out the QR codes for the Discord and also the QR code to give us the information to sign up to be a member of the roster. Thanks so much for paying attention today. I appreciate it, and we'll see you soon.